I'm Jina Na, Product Marketing Manager at AppDynamics. I hope you've been enjoying Transform so far. Thanks for joining me in this breakout session. I'm excited to talk to you about how to reduce mean time to resolution in production with deep code level visibility through a new tool discussed in this morning's keynote, Deep Code Insights powered by Rookout. Before we get started, a quick legal reminder. This session may include reference to forward-looking materials as well as forward-looking products. And as plans can change, please keep that in mind. As we know, we're living in a time of digital business, where applications are the critical touch points between businesses and their customers. And so organizations are competing in this new landscape of digital experiences. The result of that is that IT teams have really moved to the forefront of winning the digital experience battle. They're leveraging cloud technologies in order to meet the needs of digital business and the pace of innovation that's expected. It's no longer sufficient to be deploying once every 6 months when your competitor is likely deploying once a day, even multiple times per day. And so what we're seeing is that organizations are releasing faster than ever before, and deployment velocities increased exponentially. And while it's great that organizations and IT teams are leveraging the latest technologies, potentially containers, orchestration, serverless functions, and the like, to be delivering better software quicker, it's complicated the application fabric immensely. And this becomes an issue when an application performance issue occurs. In the sea of a web of different technologies, it's increasingly difficult to pinpoint where an issue might be occurring. And as you know, and as discussed in this morning's keynote, when an application issue occurs, the stakes are really high today. This can mean huge impact to the business, end users, as well as impact to organizational efficiency and productivity. So when an issue occurs, what does it look like? We're all familiar with this situation, right? The war room. The ops personnel has identified that the issue is probably being caused by some sort of code-related issue, but the developer is always right and their code is never wrong. And maybe it's something related to the network. And the NetOps team is telling you it's definitely not their network. It's a tale as old as software. So let's take a look at the troubleshooting process today when it is a code-related issue. It all starts with ops. The ops team is likely monitoring performance to make sure that the application is healthy both from a technical perspective as well as a business outcomes perspective. Is the application up and available and surfacing those critical transactions that end users are visiting the application to get? Maybe the ops team is leveraging some sort of log aggregation tool. And that tool will likely alert them when an issue does occur, but only provide very limited context. And so ops needs to spend hours inspecting logs in order to troubleshoot and triage the issue. After all of that thorough investigation, ops suspects that the issue is being caused by the application. And then there has to be a handoff. Ops asks their developers to debug and pinpoint the root cause of that issue. And that handoff is incredibly difficult and causes friction because it's very likely, especially in production, that developers don't have access to the information that they need in order to debug and pinpoint the root cause of that issue. And so what happens is that developers need to make requests to make code changes in order to add more debug statements and capture that additional information. And when I say that that handoff is challenging, it's challenging because while ops can just ask, hey, debug and tell me what's causing this issue, it takes the developers a long time to figure that out. In fact, according to a survey done by Stripe, developers are spending more than 12 hours per week only on debugging code. That's more than a full workday spent trying to identify what happened When developers are your key assets in order to be building new products, making updates, and they're spending 12 hours just debugging, that's an issue. So why does it take so much time? Let's take a look at the traditional debugging process and what it takes for that developer to gather enough information to pinpoint the root cause. Well, again, imagine that this code issue has happened in production. It's not like the ops team is just going to give access to prod, right? So the developer has to go and rebuild a QA environment in order to reproduce the issue. Then they have to make code changes to add more debug statements to capture the right data. And then they have to run it, approve it, deploy the new code, and have to wait for the results. And the reason that this is so time intensive is that at every step of that process, there's likely a challenge that could occur. Maybe the issue that's occurring in production is data related. And so it's incredibly difficult for that developer to try to reproduce that issue in some sort of pre-prod environment where the data flow and the load is not the same. In order to add more debug statements, your developer probably has to file another ops ticket, which takes more time. And even if they do add all those new log statements, they have to sift through a ton of logs in order to find the right information and diagnose the root cause. All the while, they're spending hours, potentially even days, not focused on their core job, which is writing more code and shipping better products. And at the end of all of this, if they don't have enough information that they need to pinpoint the root cause, they have to repeat it all over again. So it quickly becomes clear how those 12 hours can add up really easily. But imagine if it didn't have to be that way. Well, with Deep Code Insights powered by Rookout, debugging is as simple as clicking a button and getting the right data that they need in order to diagnose and pinpoint root cause. So instead of this traditional troubleshooting process of code issues, where there's huge friction between ops and dev, now with Deep Code Insights, you can drastically reduce mean time to resolution in production because developers have access to the information that they need on demand. In fact, with Deep Code Insights, you can see a greater than 25% improvement in developer efficiency and productivity. Let's talk about how Deep Code Insights works. In partnership with Rookout, Deep Code Insights provides a read-only view into production application data, non-intrusively and in real time. By using Deep Code Insights, you can simply add dynamic watchpoints to securely capture critical debug data needed to diagnose the root cause of performance issues. Unlike traditional breakpoints that, as the name suggests, break your application, dynamic watchpoints with Deep Code Insight briefly pauses the thread of execution at the line where they're inserted to capture that critical information without disrupting your environment or adding performance overhead. By using Deep Code Insights, you can greatly improve your developer's productivity and your organization's software delivery efficiency by giving time back to your developers to focus on building better products and releasing new features instead of debugging code. Let's take a look at how this works in action. Welcome to AD Capital, a premier banking institution. Through its application, AD Capital is allowing its clients to access key services such as applying for loans, exploring different policies, and getting quotes online. Here we're looking at AD Capital's application through the AppDynamics dashboard. Using the flow map, we can see all the different components and services that make up AD Capital's application. AppDynamics has automatically discovered this and visualized the topology of AD Capital. In this morning's keynote, you heard about how AppDynamics monitors the business transactions, or BTs. By monitoring BTs, AppDynamics is giving visibility and insight into not only the technical health of the application, as well as the business outcomes health. You can see that AppDynamics has identified three critical status business transactions. Let's dig in and see what might be going on. Here, we can see all the different business transactions, or the key user journeys, that clients of AD Capital are frequenting. I can see that the credit check business transaction AppDynamics has deemed in critical health. And I also noticed that response time seems slightly higher than other business transactions. I want to investigate further and see what might be going on and causing the performance to degrade. Let's click in. Now, we're taking a look at the credit check business transaction flow map. Here, you can see that this BT leverages one node that calls a MySQL database. You can also see from AppDynamics that there's 100% errors with this business transaction. So I definitely want to investigate and see what might be going wrong. Let's dig into the transaction snapshots that provide more information. When AppDynamics automatically detects that performance is degrading, it'll collect transaction snapshots in order to get more granular data into that business transaction and what's happening. Let's dig into one of these recent transaction snapshots in order to investigate what might be going wrong. Here, you can see that AppDynamics is telling me that there's an exception, an error occurring likely due to this divide by zero here. At this point, you're equipped with enough information to pass this along to your application development teams. You can ask them to pinpoint the root cause of the issue, but it may not be sufficient information for your developers to quickly pinpoint the root cause. As I mentioned earlier, a lot of times issues like this may be data related. And so what if the pre-production environments don't have access to the production environment data that might be causing this divide by zero? Using Deep Code Insights, let's dig deeper into the call graph and start a live debugging session to see if we can quickly pinpoint the root cause even faster. We know that there's a divide by zero occurring, and through the help of AppDynamics, it's happening in this doGet method. Let's right-click and click Debug Live in order to start a real-time debugging session using Deep Code Insights. Now we're in Deep Code Insights powered by Rookout. You'll notice that the UI reflects an IDE, or an integrated development environment, so that your users, your developers, can easily navigate source code in an intuitive UI. Here, we're at the doGet method that AppDynamics has told me an issue is occurring. I want to investigate further. Let's see where we should add dynamic watch points in order to capture the critical debug data needed to identify and pinpoint what root cause of this issue is. AppDynamics told me that there's a division by zero occurring that's causing this issue. My eye is immediately drawn to line 67, where you see a division by COEF. I want to find out what are the values of this variable COEF. Let's use a dynamic watch point in order to capture more information. As I mentioned earlier, using dynamic watch points is as simple as clicking a button. Simply click a button in order to insert a new watch point at any line of code. Once it turns purple, you'll see that the dynamic watch point has been activated. Once activated, the dynamic watch point starts creating messages. Let's pull up these messages and see what Deep Code Insights has to say. You can see from the information that Deep Code Insights is providing that the coefficient value is equal to zero. This matches the information that AppDynamics has told us, where there's a division by zero causing this exception and causing the credit check business transaction to perform poorly. Now, we've pinpointed the root cause of this issue being the coefficient equals zero. Instead of having to sift through a ton of log files, make any code changes and redeploy in order to add log statements, you were able to simply click a button, add a dynamic watch point, wait a few seconds, and catch the right information you need. Now, with these dynamic watch points, you don't have to worry about impacting your application. A dynamic watch point will briefly pause the thread of execution at the line at which it's inserted, capture the right data it needs, and then release the thread. So what you get are messages full of rich information that you need to pinpoint root cause without causing any impact to end users, the application, or adding any performance overhead. Another thing you'll notice is that Deep Code Insights collects this information in a very secure manner. You'll see any personal identifiable information can be redacted so that not all users can view this information. Now that we've saved so much time and pinpointed the root cause using dynamic watch points, you can simply share this information from DCI in order to equip your developers to confidently make a fix. Using one of the many extensions, you can also set different destination targets for your breakpoints. You'll see common users of DCI are leveraging Slack. Now that we have information using AppDynamics and Deep Code Insights, we can easily pinpoint the root cause of application code issues without having to spend time sifting through log files. And instead, now your developers can focus on what matters most, which is building new products and releasing new features that drive innovation and meet the business needs. Now that we've seen Deep Code Insights in action, let's recap what I've discussed before wrapping up. In order to compete and win the digital experience battle, organizations are leveraging more cloud technologies and deploying faster than ever before. And just as we've evolved the way that teams can build better products at neck-breaking speeds, let's evolve our strategy to equip our developers with real-time debugging so that they can pinpoint the root cause of application code issues. By using Deep Code Insights, IT teams can drastically reduce mean time to resolution in production and innovate faster by reducing the time spent debugging code. Finally, last but not least, you can achieve tighter dev and ops alignment for organizational efficiency. As next steps, I encourage you to attend Simplify Microservices Monitoring with Code Visibility, Visualization, and Alerting breakout session hosted by my colleague. You can also discover more product information, request a demo, and sign up for beta programs we're offering at this link above. For AppDynamics customers, we're offering 60-day free trials of Deep Code Insights, so please get in touch through that link to get started. Thank you for joining me today.